Part 2. Crimson Flower. Great Tree Moon. To the End of a Dream. After defeating the Kingdom Army and King Dimitri on the Tailteen Plains, Imperial forces set their sights on Ferdiad, the Kingdom capital. The final battle against Rhea draws near.
So, we have finally arrived. It has been a very, very long road.
Why are you here, Uncle? We haven't prevailed just yet.
Even better. I decided I wanted to see the end with my own eyes. The very moment that humans will finally be free from the control of that false beast of a goddess.
Understood. Behold to your heart's content. Just don't get in our way.
Of course. I could not stand to be dragged into the fighting. When this fight is over, a world completely controlled by the Empire will be upon us.
Not completely. I will only do what I must. But until our reign becomes stable... Uncle, no, all of you. I believe that your power and knowledge may be essential during that time of transition.
Perhaps so. We also will do what we must. For that short while, we will lend you our strength.
Yes, we're counting on you. For now. Professor, may I speak with you? I know the timing is less than ideal, but there's something I need to tell you. I imagine you've already sensed it, but even still, I must tell you the truth of the power you wield and of what you are. I expected as much. You, like Rhea, share a bloodline with the so-called goddess. Your mother likely had some connection to the goddess, whose power has always been sleeping within you. 5 years ago, when your power awakened, I was afraid you would choose to join with Rhea. I did. As you know, my goal is to free our world from the control of Rhea and the other children of the goddess. I seek to obliterate her, as well as those around her who use the Church's power to control Fodlan. I swore to free the people from Rhea by striking her down, whether or not it meant making an enemy of you. And yet, you came to my aid and chose to walk with me on the path against Rhea. I was overjoyed, of course, but I was also confused. I thought that perhaps it wasn't the path you were meant to take. But I chose to trust in you, to rely on you and your strength. And now, here we are. Thank you for listening, my teacher. I'm glad I finally had the chance to talk to you about it. After Rhea is gone from this world, I don't know what will become of you. But whatever happens, I hope you know that you're very special to me. You are the one person in this world who can share the heavy burden I must carry. Someone without equal, who I can always speak my mind to. It's time. Let's go, Professor.
The Imperial Army arrives in Ferdiad, the Kingdom capital, only to be confronted by Rhea, who has transformed into the Immaculate One. The Black Eagle Strike Force steels itself for an epic battle, hoping to soon return Fodlan to its people.
Rhea, members of the Church of Saros, surely there's no need to continue this fight. What could be gained by shutting yourselves inside the capital of a kingdom without a king? I will give you this one chance, and no other. Throw down your weapons and surrender. Unlike you, I have no desire to unleash wicked atrocities upon this world.
Their silence speaks volumes. Shall we commence our attack?
I'll wait just a moment longer. There are still many residents within the city. Unlike my attack on Garrick Mach 5 years ago, The church will not allow the inhabitants to evacuate. What the hell are they planning?
Lady Rhea, or rather, Lady Saros, the Imperial Army is calling for our surrender. Is it wise to ignore them? Perhaps we could leave Fodlan and devise another plan.
We shall not surrender! We must not lose! Even if it must split the heavens, we shall not yield to the Wicked Ones!
Understood. I will do as you command. You have my fealty no matter what, until my last moment of life.
I'll stay by your side too, forever.
Now, Catherine, set fire to the city. The Imperial Army will burn in the flames of eternal torment.
What? No, you can't do that!
Catherine, now.
As you wish. But is there truly no other way?
I have no patience for foolish questions. I shall sacrifice as many lives as it takes. That apostate who insists on taking everything from me will be crushed by my own hands!
That ghastly voice.
Your Majesty! There's smoke coming from every corner of the capital. It seems they've set fire to the city.
What? Damn it, Rhea. There really is no depth you wouldn't sink to. Everyone, we must commence our attack at once. Are you ready?
Preparations are complete. Just say the word.
Then we attack. We'll head straight for the castle and strike down their leader. Rhea, that vile creature called the Immaculate One. This is the end of our long war. After this victory, Fodlan will finally be united and truly free. The capital we're about to invade is engulfed in flames. Do not rush to your deaths. Survive. Prevail. Do that and we'll witness the birth of a new world. I want to see it with all of you at my side. Understood?
Of course. I will not fall and leave you without your protector. And you may live to see your dream come to fruition. For that, I shall survive and prevail.
I am carrying the future of Brigid. I will not be dying here. I will be winning for myself and for everyone. I will be surviving.
We've been cutting our own path this whole way. There's no stopping until we reach the end. I can't die, or all my great work so far will have been wasted.
Don't worry about me, AD. I won't fall before I've found my happily ever after. Maybe when this war is over, I can finally snag a good catch and settle down.
Somehow we're already here. I wonder if the peace we secure will allow me to research as much as I'd like. If so, let's end this quickly.
Edelgard, Professor, I'll do my best for both of you. If I die here, it would be with shame and regret. Oh, I can't let that happen!
Once the world is united, I will lend my strength to both Edelgard and the Professor. To that end, I will lead us all safely to victory. My pride and duty as a noble demand no less, as do my own principles.
Imperial Army, Black Eagle Strike Force, move out!
It's so awful to see the Kingdom Capital go up in flames. But at least we made it this far. We finally stand before the palace. These flames will kill our friends and foes alike.
Those who stand in our way will perish with the flames. Immaculate One, your reign ends here and now.
With fire raging all over the city, our enemies won't be able to advance in large numbers. Instead, they may try to defeat us with small squads of elite warriors.
Indeed. I suspect as much. And at their head is the one who stole my mother from me, and likely that mutinous whelp, Edelgard.
The whole city's burning! Oh, this isn't good. I'm flammable, you know?
If possible, we must be avoiding the flame and be careful of strong enemies.
If we want to minimize our losses, we will need to be flexible in our approach.
For the Empire!
I do not tolerate obstacles.
What's my strategy?
It's over!
All is going to plan.
No time for accolades.
Ready for anything.
I will see this war through.
I'm impressed. There's no stopping me.
I'm awake.
I do this for all of us.
Back to the fray.
This is the cost of war.
Put me in there.
I'll cut a bloody path.
I will prevail.
More fighting.
Sally Forge!
Understood.
accept your fate. The Immaculate Roar saves only the righteous.
What? Her howl was unadulterated magic. I didn't know such a display of power was possible.
That roar seems to have affected the doll's movements.
Whenever the Immaculate One howls, those dolls become stronger.
Death grows more distant.
Attention.
only thorns left on this rose. I'll try harder too.
Turn the tides.
Our king, you've torn them all apart. Haven't you had enough? What else is there for you to take? I tried to do the right thing, Lenato.
good assist.
Run, Nefren.
It's now or never.
See this war through.
Within reach.
I think I'd let you go.
I was trusted to protect the future of the nation, the royal bloodline itself. I cannot yield. I will fulfill my duty, even if I must forfeit my life. My promise to you, I could not.
Don't worry, Father. I will protect the capital and the whole kingdom.
Dreams demand this.
Strategy.
Yeah! Great.
Get away from Lady Rhea!
Let's try something special. Forth. ready for anything.
Lady Rhea, thank you for everything.
My strategy.
Well done.
Understood. So.
Put me in there.
I'll cut a bloody path. Her will demands it. To kill is to grow stronger.
There's no stopping me.
Sally Ford!
There's no stopping me. The roar of battle.
I'm only getting better with age.
I will prevail. My heart burns with pride. Hard work is a friend to count on.
Remain cautious.
I do this for all of us. Thank you. Each battle a victory. I work to grow.
I'm awake.
Inspired.
More fighting.
I owe you one.
Empire.
Put me in there.
I'll defend this place with my very life!
Ready for anything.
My strategy. One day, the... Why, Professor? Why must we fight like this? Surely there was another path you could have taken that wouldn't have led to this.
Understood.
I will prevail. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
burns with pride. Everyone's equal in battle.
Humanity of its folly. You still wish to hurt and betray my mother and myself.
So it's true. You don't value human life at all. Isn't that right, Immaculate One?
Nonsense! Fools who do not accept their own sins are undeserving of salvation! You humans are the ones who betrayed! You betrayed me, and you betrayed my mother!
I did not betray you or her. I never believed in you from the beginning.
Thank you.
Humanity stands strong, and people reach out for each other. There's no need for gods. Rhea, your reign of tyranny is over. The time has come. I'm ending this once and for all!
Is it over?
Oh!